Hey guys, this is a very basic video on how to say do sidechain compression in Logic. Very simple. Alright, here's a kick. It's just a mono blank audio channel. Okay, that's all that is. Here's some kicks. I'll drag it into my sequencer like so. Press option if you want, and if you press option and then click on it and then drag it, it just copies it. So we got our kick there. It's certainly not a kick I'd use in any of my songs, but anyway, it's just a kick. It's all we need. Because a kick is, we're going to use a kick to trigger a compressor on a bass line or any synth. And basically when that kick triggers the compressor, it lowers the volume of that synth, and the kick is able to stand on its own, and you know, able to, you can hear the kick clearly because it moves the synth out of the way just while the kick is kicking. So that's what it does. So I've got the kicks there, but what the best way to do it is, you want to create like a ghost kick, a kick that's there to trigger the compressor only, and one that can't be heard. So we use this as the one that we can hear. So just make another duplicate channel. Move those down there. I'm going to call this one Sidechain. And I usually make them a different color so I can tell in my song. Make them black. Okay. It's important to use the exact same kick for your sidechain compression as the one that you're using in this song, okay? So it's perfectly matched up. You can use a hi-hat or anything to trigger a compressor for sidechain compression, but it would give you different lengths of sidechaining because a closed hat is a very quick sound, so you'd only get very quick sidechain compression. You want to use the exact same sample of your kick for your sidechain compression trigger. So we're still on the sidechaining one. Just simply go down to out and click no output. So you can see it down here pumping away, okay? But it's not going to be heard. It's just going to simply trigger the compressor. But you can hear now, you'll be able to hear our normal kick going. So that's just from that one kick that we use in our song, okay? Here's our baseline patch. Go down into here. Insert a compressor. Now when you look up in this top corner here, sidechain, you've got two to choose from. Don't use that one there. Just use the ghost kick, audio 2. Okay. Now, just record that for a second. You can use different settings here basically, but you're already compressing it, so just play with the attack, the release, the gain, the compressor threshold, the ratio, and that's basically how you get the synth to compress, sidechain compress against the kick. More aggressive, I'll use the VCA, put the attack almost right down. That's it. And now the reason we use a ghost kick is, say there's a part of the song where you don't want your synth to be sidechained, okay, so say in a breakdown, you can just put this kick wherever you want, okay, so say We made this longer. Like so. It should be that you'll hear up to here, you'll hear it sidechaining, and then for these last two it won't sidechain because I haven't put the ghost kick here. Okay, so wherever you put the ghost kick, that's where it's going to be sidechaining. Alright, thanks guys.